Okay, small signal operation and modeling. So here it is a circuit of common source amplifier. So we are playing a input at the gate terminal and taking output at the drain terminal. So here it is, we are worried about a small signal. So small signal is in terms of AC, and the DC is required for the biasing. So here the notations are, you have to observe carefully. Capital V with capital GS is a DC voltage, and small with small gs is a AC signal, or a small signal, that is input signal to be amplified. And a small v with capital gs is a sum of both DC and AC. Similarly, in current, ID, a small I with capital D is amplified output, or amplified drain current, amplified output current, whereas capital ID is a DC drain. And coming to the signal current is both are small. Small I with small d is a signal current. Similarly, in terms of voltage also, so the voltage is capital VD, capital V, capital D is a DC current, a DC voltage, and small V with small d is a signal amplified voltage. The signal voltage at V with capital D is a small v, or tilted V with capital D is a output voltage. Small VGS is, as you know, that it is input voltage. So here in this, we are going to find out what is the current at the drain terminal. We need to derive an expression for this particular small signal, and then we need to find out what is the DC bias point. First, the first thing is, before going to design any amplifier, we should know what is the DC bias point or operating points. So I mean to say, here we need to find out ID and VGS. Those are the load line points. So after that, we have to find out the drain current at the current at the drain terminal. Then we need to find out the voltage gain of this particular small signal as an amplifier. I hope the notations is clear with this notations, all of you. Next, we'll move on to the DC bias point. So here, as I told you, DC bias current as capital ID can be going to be found out when you are measuring a one voltage, when you are making other voltage is zero. So in this case, when measuring DC bias point, we'll be making the small signal or a small VGS to zero. We'll be worried about only the DC one. So you will get the saturation drain current, that is saturation DC current. So that is capital ID is equal to, the capital ID is a DC drain current. So if you want to use on any transistor as an amplifier, the MOSFET has to be in the saturation region. The saturation current expression for MOSFET is like this. ID is equal to 1 by 2. The process transconductance parameter Kn dash, and aspect ratio, I can say it is W by L into VGS minus VT the whole square. So capital VGS, it is DC gate source voltage, minus VT is the threshold voltage whole square. Okay, so this is about DC current. So now we have to find out DC voltage at the drain terminal, so that we can write as the DC voltage as VDS, or source is grounded, I can also write it as VD, capital VD. So capital VD is a DC drain voltage. Be careful with the notations. So now, so if you apply a KVL at the outer loop, So what you are going to get if you apply KVL to the outer loop, VD is equal to VDD minus voltage across resistor. Yes, VD is equal to the supply voltage minus voltage across the resistor RD. So that is VD is equal to VDD minus voltage across RD. So voltage across RD is ID into RD. I am very much particular about DC voltage and DC current. Okay, we will call this equation as equation 2. Any doubt in these two expressions?
No.
Next, if you want to ensure the transistor in the saturation region, I told you when we are discussing about drain to gate feedback as a biasing technique. So here, when you want to make sure that your device in saturation is by applying this condition, VD is greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. So this is a condition to ensure the transistor has to be in the saturation region. Always the total voltage at the drain will be having a signal component. It will be superimposed on DC, that is capital VD. So the VD drain voltage, DC drain voltage has to be sufficiently greater than VGS minus VT to allow for the required signal amplification. We'll move on to the signal current in the drain terminal. So here we are going to apply the input signal. So whereas in the previous case we made AC signal as 0 to measure the DC drain current, now we are worried about the signal drain current. So your input signal will be a small VGS is applied, small V with small V, small GS is applied. So now what is the total instantaneous gate to source voltage? That is your tilted V with capital GS. What is the total instantaneous voltage now?
Capital VGS plus the signal VGS.
It is DC plus AC. So DC is capital V with GS plus signal is a small V with GS. It is the sum of DC plus AC. So now I'll call it this equation as 1. Now I need to find out the total instantaneous drain current. So the total instantaneous drain current I am going to denote as small I with capital D. This is the instantaneous total drain current. So as you all know that the current will be the saturation current expression. It is 1 by 2 Kn dash with aspect ratio W by L into VGS minus VT the whole square. So this is an instantaneous drain current. So the respective voltage will be tilted V with capital VGS minus VT the whole square. Now you need to substitute the value of VGS, tilted V with the GS. What is the value?
1. VGS should be small right now. Signal only.
Yes, this is small only. This is not signal, this is instantaneous drain current respective instantaneous drain voltage, instantaneous gate source voltage. That is a small V with capital GS, tilted or small. So it is V with capital GS. So So this is the sum of AC plus DC. So now in the next step, I'm going to substitute the small tilted VGS value. So it will be of Kn dash W by L. This will be retained the same. This whole into VGS is a sum of DC capital VGS plus signal small v small gs minus Vt whole square. Now I just manipulate this expression. Only I am rearranging the VGS value. So VGS does this W by L. I'll group in a such a way that VGS capital V VGS minus Vt plus small VGS the whole square. Just I've rearranged it, that's it. Any doubt in this step? Okay. Now you just imagine this is A and this is B. A plus B the whole square form. So what you are going to get now? So of let it be retained. Just expand in the form A plus B whole square. A is your VGS minus VT. So I'll write in this square bracket. So now A square is capital VGS minus VT the whole square. This makes A square plus or I'll write because 2AB, 2 into A is VGS minus VT into small v into GS plus B square. B square is VGS square. Shall I continue? Just have expanded A plus B whole square form. A square plus 2AB plus B square. Now, let me multiply this off into Kn dash W by L inside the bracket. So, if I multiply this off into Kn dash W by L with capital VGS minus Vt the whole square plus half into Kn dash W by L into 2 into VGS minus VT into VGS plus half into Kn dash W by L VGS square. Now just observe, you have three terms here. This two and this two get cancelled. We'll be retaining Kn dash W by L VGS minus VT into VGS. Okay, what is about first term here? What is about exactly it is? The first term?
ID.
Yeah, what and ID? Capital I with capital D or small I with capital D?
Capital I, capital D.
Capital I, capital D, because it is a DC voltage, capital VGS, so it is a DC current ID. So next, the second term is about the current component, what we have, Kn dash W by L, VGS minus VT into VGS. So here, ID is directly proportional to signal voltage, that is input signal. And the third term is, the ID is proportional to VGS square. So what will happen, VGS is small, again VGS square will be still less. So here it leads to a non-linear distortion. Okay, so just we'll equate this current components. First term, as you told, it is capital ID, it is DC bias current ID. The second term, let me equate, ID is equal to, it is a Kn dash W by L VGS minus VT into small VGS. So here you can observe this ID is directly proportional to the signal component VGS, that is input signal. So next third term is, your ID is directly proportional to square of the input signal. So what we have to do is, in order to remove this non-linear distortion, we have to maintain this third signal should be much, the third term should be much, much less than the second term. So let me write that. I hope this is clear with this expressions.
Yes.
Okay, I'll continue next slide. Okay, here to reduce the nonlinear distortion, we are going to write the second term. What is the second term? Third term, it is half into Kn dash W by L, that is VGS square. Always this should be much, much less than, what is your second term? It is
Kn dash by W by L.
Kn dash W by L.
VGS
minus VT into VGS.
Into VGS. Now, so this Kn dash W by L will get cancelled, and one VGS is get cancelled. It is equal to small VGS.
Less than or less than?
Two times.
VGS.
VGS minus VT. Okay. So VGS is much, much less than 2 times VGS minus VT. I call this equation as equation 4. So I can also written as VGS minus VT as VOV, more dry voltage. So I can write it as VGS much, much less than 2 times VO. Okay, well, VO is a overdrive voltage at which the transistor is operating. So next is the continuation with this. If the small signal condition is satisfied, if this condition is satisfied, we may neglect last equation, the last term in the equation. So I can write it as the amplified drain current, capital small I with capital D, as the first term, as you are told, it is DC bias current ID, but second term is the signal one, small I with small d. Okay, so what is the second term? ID is equal to, ID is Kn dash. So this is the second term. Okay, we have compared with the third one. So Kn dash W by L VGS minus VT into small v GS. This is a signal current. So now the parameter that relates ID and VGS is known as transconductance. So as you know that in BJT also, GM is a transconductance, it is a reverse of resistance. So it is current by voltage, so that is ID by VGS. So ID small I small d by the signal voltage VGS. So what will happen if you manipulate this equation? ID and VGS is shifted to the denominator, so left out is K dash W by L VGS minus VT. So now it can also be written as GM is equal to KN dash W by L VOV. This is alternate formula for GM. Okay. Any doubt in the expression, the transconductance? The drain current, the current at the drain terminal is this, K dash W by L, VGS minus VT into VGS. One and only, if this condition, the signal has to be always much, much less than 2 VOV. So that is, the condition has to be satisfied. Then if you find out the transconductance is ID by VGS, so K and dash W by L VGS minus VT. So there are two different ways we can write for GM. A GM is equal to K and dash W by L into VOV. So next, we have a graphical interpretation of small signal operation of enhancement MOSFET amplifier. So same sort I have shown you for BJT, IC versus the input VBE. So now it is input output current versus the input voltage, that is the sum of DC and AC. This is tilted V with capital GS. You can observe the input they are giving here. So input is a superimposition of DC, that is, you have a DC line here. On that, it is AC signal is superimposing on this. So we have taken here a triangular waveform, input triangular. We can take sinusoidal also. So the linear region. So almost a linear segment is going to have a bias point Q. So from this, you will get an amplified signal at the drain terminal. So if you find out the slope will be ID by VGS. It is tilted V with GS because it is x-axis. So tilted V with capital GS. So now GM is equal to slope of ID VGS characteristic at the bias point. So GM will be dou ID by dou VGS at tilted VGS is equal to capital VGS. So this is a slope of this transfer characteristics. Tilted V with GS is a sum of DC plus AC. Is this clear with the curve? So you can observe, you applied a small signal, so you can observe the output across the. This is an amplified output. So this is I with small d is a F signal component. So here it is a overdrive voltage. It is VGS minus VT. You can say it is a overdrive voltage. In order to satisfy VGS, it should be 2 times VOV. The VGS has to be twice is VOV, much less than 2 times VOV. That is, just now we derived it. So VGS should satisfy this condition. Yes, shall I continue?
Yes, Miss Ma'am.
Next we'll move on to the voltage gain. So voltage, in order to find out voltage gain, we need to find out the total instantaneous drain voltage. The instantaneous drain voltage is tilted V with capital D is equal to, that is, we have applied a KVL, VDD minus ID, that is capital ID into small I capital D into RD. So as we all know that ID is equal to what in the previous expression? I small I with capital D is, what is the value here? It is capital ID plus
small id.
So I can replace this value, the sum of the drain current, as VDD minus small id capital ID plus small I into D into RD. So if I simplify this, we'll get VDD minus capital ID RD minus small I small d RD. What is this VDD minus ID RD? We have told you in the first beginning only. VDD minus ID RD is, we have written expression first, yes. Immediate after circuit.
VDS.
VDS. Or I can say it is capital V with a D, that is DC bias voltage, and this is a signal component. I don't want to worry about this. I have to worry about the signal component. So let me write this expression as a small v or a tilted v with capital D is equal to minus the signal component. So I need not worry about the DC. I have to worry about the signal. So from this, and also, what is ID in terms of GM? as you all know that GM is equal to current by voltage. So here it is a drain current by the gate source voltage. So from this, what is ID? ID is equal to GM into VGS. So let me substitute ID value here in terms of GM. GM into VGS into RD. So we have to find out the voltage gain. The voltage gain can be denoted as AV. So now what is output voltage? Output voltage is for the signal. Small d. Is an output voltage. Okay. So V is an input voltage. So actually gain is total voltage. So what is the input voltage? Small V with D. So if you substitute small V with small D is minus Vm into small VGS into R V by VGS. So VGS get cancelled. We'll be getting final expression as GM into RD. This is the voltage gain. So your minus sign indicates that output signal small v if the D is 180 degree out of phase with respect to input signal. So we can observe in this, this is the input, this is the delay, this is the delay. Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay, let me write a small signal model of MOSFET like your BJT hybrid pi model we have written. So equivalent, small signal equivalent circuit model by considering the common source amplifier. So the model is like this. So I'm going to write the three terminals. Okay, so the three terminals are, I'll label it this as gate and this is source, this is drain. Okay. So now there is a current flows from which terminal? Where I am supposed to include the current source here? Like your BJT itself, same. Between which terminal I have to include the current source? In MOSFET, enhancement MOSFET, the current flows from which terminal to which terminal? I'm talking about common source. Source is grounded. It's going to give input at the gate, measuring output at the drain. The current flows from drain to. So this is input you are going to give at the gate. The input is for small signal, small V, small GS. So there is a current flows from drain to source. So you are supposed to include the current source between the drain and source. The direction is down arrow. The current has to flow from drain to source. What is ID? IV is small d. ID is?
Signal current.
Signal current. That is GM into VGS.
VGS.
Yes. Okay. Similarly, about including the effect of channel length modulation. So channel length modulation is not according to your syllabus, but I'll take one class and I'll tell you what exactly the channel length modulation. So now this is without channel length modulation. So that is lambda is equal to zero. So we're not including any lambda term in the ID expression. If I write the model with respect to the channel length modulation, so same thing, source, we have a signal component, VGS, this is gate, drain, the current source, with a small input resistance, output resistance, R0. We are going to include R0 when you are considering channel length modulation effect, CLM. So again it is GM into VGS, this current. R0 is the finite output resistance. Okay. So R0 can be defined as early voltage by drain current, VA by ID. I'll tell you this, I'll take one class. I'm going to explain you what is exactly the channel length modulation. So what will happen here is, so the channel is going to be pinched off at the drain terminal. Okay, or I can say, if you increase the VDS value, the shape of the channel is going to be tapered at the drain side. The channel is going to be more towards the source end. That is nothing but channel length modulation. So I'll take up and I'll explain you how the channel is going to be moved and how it will affect on the drain current. Okay. So this is a structure of your MOSFET, right? So you have two heavily doped regions here, N plus. So to form a drain and source. So actual channel is like this, right? So the channel is uniform in the triode region or linear region. So what will happen if you increase the VDS value, the channel is going to be take a shape of a tapered shape. The tapered shape in the sense, the channel is going to be, the shape of the channel is like this. So this is going to be pinched off at the drain. Actually in the triode region it was uniform. In the saturation region it is going to be pinched off at the drain side and it is a shift in the channel. So the channel length will be vary. We can say it is a channel length modulation. The changes in the channel length. Okay. Yes, is this clear with the concept?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now try to solve one problem. Okay, just try to find out this. A MOSFET is to operate at ID is equal to 0.1 milliamps and is to have a GM is 1 milliamps per volt. If Kn dash is 50 microamps per V square, it is V square actually, find the required W by L ratio and the overdrive voltage. Okay, so you have to remember your three formulas for GM. So GM, as you all know, that GM is equal to ID into
RD,
that is the voltage gain, and you have ID is equal to GM into
ID by V.
And one more
ID by VG.
No, no, we one more you have. I've written two more alternate formulas. Go to GM after drain current. Drain current derivation attraction on GM expression is already.
IC by VT, no?
No, that is BJT.
K in dash into W by L.
Yes, K in dash into W by L. From this, can you find out easily W by L? GM is known, K in dash is known. Yes or no? So here, there are given ID value here, and they are also given GM. K in dash is also given. We need to find out W by L ratio. So can you find out W by L from this formula? Just K in dash by W L or K in dash by W by L into VOV?
VOV.
VOV.
Yes, into VOV. Now, these two are unknown now. Okay. You have to find out VOV or W by L. Then you can go back to this. How to find out W by L? Plus W by L, we have to find out. How to find out that? This is
when we need to find VGS.
Yes, we need to find out VGS. Okay, try to solve this problem and give me the solution by next class. Okay.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, note down all of you this problem. So test is rescheduled to 28th, next Monday, 28, 2030. So this completes module 1. So you have to solve few more problems in this module 1. Okay. So this module 1 is about biasing techniques and small signal operation in models. We have completed for both BHDT and MOSFET. And let me have more problems on MOSFET as well as BJT. Then we'll go with second module. So complete first module will be there for your test, filters and multivibrators. Thank you. Okay, so leave the session now.
Yes, ma'am.